So now I'll start a topic which is called as special topics in conduction heat transfer. Here I will take two types of problem. First, which I called as multi-solid heat conduction problem, and the second which I call as non-linear heat conduction problem. So with this, the idea is to introduce to you, like in fluid we have multi-phase flow, okay. So what happens in, what is multi-phase flow? Two different fluid flowing, like you can have boiling, condensation, you can have two fluid stratified flow, let us say oil water flowing in a pipe together where they are separated. So in multi-phase flow you have interfaces. So analogously, one can teach multi-phase flow simulation as an advanced course on CFD, but to introduce you the concept of interface in conduction, I thought that let us have multi-solid heat conduction. But the difference between the multi-solid and multi-fluid is that in multi-fluid the interface moves with respect to time, whereas in this case of multi-solid heat transfer, in if there is no melting, the interface between the two solid will be fixed. So the interface is fixed here, whereas in multi-phase flow the interface changes with respect to time. So when you solve a multi-phase flow problem computationally, you need an additional equation for moving the interface, which is not needed here, and because the interface is fixed, no melting. So to give idea about the, when we have two different solids, how you take care of the conductivity, because at the interface the question comes is that what should be the conductivity. So those questions will be answered here. The second problem, nonlinear heat conduction. Nonlinearity mainly you see in fluid mechanics, but there is one case at least where you get a nonlinearity in heat conduction, when conductivity becomes function of temperature. I think someone asked you that, asked me in the yesterday's lecture that. So I am, anyway we teach this in our undergraduate CFD course, so I am taking two topics into that. This I call as special topics. One may find nothing special about it, but just for a beginner I think it's special. Okay, so let us take a simple problem. Let us take a square plate made up of four materials of equal size: copper, iron, stainless steel and aluminium. And let us suppose, as you know, by this time you may be knowing that I use, when I take example problem, I use two types of boundary condition: one, all Dirichlet; second, all possible boundary condition. So let us suppose left wall is 100, bottom wall is 200, right wall 300, top wall 400 degree centigrade. Now here, for a beginner in CFD, this is the simplest grid generation: equispaced horizontal and vertical lines. I would like to, so these are the grid points which I had shown earlier also. I would like to draw your attention into this. What is this? Interface between the two different materials. I am showing it by red lines, because this is where we have to focus mainly, otherwise the problem is easy. The only difference which lies in this is this interface. We are considering the heat transfer that there is no melting, so interface will not change with respect to time. The computational stencil remains like this. So if I take a stencil which is border as far as this material is concerned, then when you apply, as you know by this time, that the way we solve in finite volume method is that we have to calculate heat fluxes on the different phases. So when you want to calculate heat flux at this phase, what will be the conductivity you use? You know that to calculate heat flux you need conductivity by Fourier law of heat conduction. And note that I have generated the grid in such way that the solid, two solid interface lies at the face of the control volume, not at the cell center of the control volume. Correct? Even the problems which we will be giving you in the lab session today, we will tell you that enter the even number of grid points, so that at least we ensure that the interface is coinciding with the face of the control volume. Okay. So the question, the only question I would say in this case is that how to calculate K at the interface. these are the boundary, border and interior control volume that I'd explain it. Here we use, so the conductivity is calculated using simple idea which you teach in, let us say, undergraduate fluid mechanics course. So the idea is this, that let us suppose I have plate, here we use one dimensional approximation. So let us suppose you have plate made of two different materials and the thickness of one plate is delta x by 2, the second thickness of the second material is again delta x by 2. Okay, then what you do, you use the resistance concept. What is the resistance concept? The difference, so I am using, you are using one dimensional conduction between the two grid points only. So the temperature difference divided by the thermal resistance. What is the temperature difference? T capital E minus T capital P divided by, so you use the resistance concept. And the what is, how do you calculate resistance concept? Resistance, thermal resistance in a material, L by Ka. So what is the length here? Delta X E by 2 and the conductivity is Ke 2 and here it is Ke 1. So these are the thermal resistance and they are in series. Okay. So using this resistance concept, you can equate this to an equivalent conductivity also, and then you can get a relationship between the equivalent conductivity and Ke1 and Ke2, the conductivity of the two different materials. Is that clear? So the point is that, let us suppose if you take one material, let us say this copper, if, so in this material you will generate some control volume. And in those control volume, there will be phase center, certain number of phase center, horizontal phase center, vertical phase center. Those phase center which are lying at the boundary, for those you need to, so the phase center which is lying at the boundary, let us say here, you need to use a different K. You cannot use K of this or K of this. And that harmonic mean of K which you will calculate, which will be used as Qx for the east face of this and west face of this. So there will be continuity of heat flux, note that. There is no jump of heat fluxes. There is no what we call as contact thermal resistance. Contact thermal resistance is taken as 0 in this case. So with that, using, so that is the difference which you have to, the way the, we will give you the code which has been generated in such a way that everywhere it calculates the harmonic mean, but the thing is that if there is a change, it calculates the correct ones, but it unnecessarily calculates for the interior grid points also. Is this correct, Vishesh?
Yeah.
So for simplicity, you will see that in our code generation, we are doing some lot of unnecessary things you may feel, but this is the simplest way of thinking and doing. So for a beginner in CFD code development, we felt that this, the way I defined that QX, QY grid point also, that's also not necessary, that's not an efficient way of code development. But for a beginner, I think it's okay to get a feel of it while you are developing a code. Okay, now let us take this problem. So the solution algorithm remains more or less same what I taught. So I'm not discussing the implementation details, solution algorithm, those are same what I taught in the previous lecture. So using all those, if you do this modification in the code and if you run the code for this, then you get a movie of the temperature contours, which is as like this. Left wall 100, bottom wall 200, right wall 300, top wall 400 degree centigrade. This is the unsteady simulation. You have a series of picture of isotherms at different time instants and it reaches to finally a steady state. I had shown this problem earlier also. What is the difference between the isotherm here and the earlier case? Yeah, that there is a discontinuity. There is a discontinuity of the interface at the interface between the two different solids. So there is a change in the, let us say, temperature gradient across the interface, and the change in temperature gradient across the interface is inversely proportional to the conductivity ratios, because basically Fourier law of heat conduction has to apply at the interface. Okay. So there is a continuity of heat flux. So there will be as the conductivity is different, so if you apply Fourier law of conduction, it says that there should be change in the slope of the isotherms. That is what you are getting here. Okay. Now let us take the second problem. Second problem will be left wall 100, bottom wall insulated, right wall constant heat flux, top wall convective boundary conditions. For this case, if you generate the animation, it will look like this. bottom wall is insulated, you always see that each time step, each isotherm is hitting the bottom wall perpendicular. Right wall, constant heat flux, the isotherms are hitting with at a constant angle, but that constant angle is different in the top portion and the bottom portion because you have two different materials, note that. Just see, it is hitting normally. Here it is hitting at a constant angle on the top part, a different constant angle in the bottom part because you have two different materials. Okay, so this is the steady state temperature distribution. Okay, so before I move into next topic, if you have any question, I'll be happy to answer. Okay, so if there is no question, let us move to the next topic. Next topic is non-linear heat conduction. As I mentioned that in heat conduction, there are very few cases where you get non-linearity, and one of the cases is that if conductivity becomes function of temperature. So let us suppose conductivity varies in a linear fashion, K0 1 plus Bt, where K0 and B are constants, and this B can be positive or it could be negative. And there are certain materials for which we know K0 and B are given. I will show you in the next slide. And the good thing is that for this case, we can obtain the analytical solution also. So this is, you can obtain the exact solution by just integrating, and this I am telling you, you can obtain analytical solution for the steady state situation, note that, not for the unsteady state. For the steady state situation, this will be 0, and then you just integrate it twice using this K expression and you will get this exact solution. So the objective of this, we will take a problem and we will, I will show you how the, what is the solution algorithm and how code is developed. Once you develop a code, you can test it with the exact solution. So you can we use for validation, code validation. The finite volume discretization, if you do, you will get unsteady term, diffusion term as this. So thermal conductivity, just for reference, I am showing you that for stainless steel, what is the value of K0 and B, and for pure iron, at less than 1000 Kelvin, what is the value of K and B. Note that B is positive for stainless steel and negative for iron, although the value of B is very small. So here the solution algorithm procedure is same what I discussed earlier. The only difference which we need is that here you find that after each time step, as at each grid point temperature is changing and your conductivity is a function of grid point temperature, so K will change with respect to time. Okay, so K is changing with respect to time and temperature calculation depend on K. So it's a coupled equations. What in CFD we do is that we solve one equation at a time. So let us suppose I solve K using the temperature of previous time level. Once I get updated value of K, I solve the heat conduction equation. It can be vice versa also. So I'm just suggesting that let us calculate conductivity using the old time level and then use the updated K to calculate temperature at the new time level. So in this case, calculation of K is lagged by one time step. I'll take an example problem. If you take that stainless steel iron B, you don't get much change in the curve. Steady state linear curve is one dimension, it's a linear curve. But if you take that B of iron and stainless steel, there is hardly any change. So I wanted to show you some appreciable change. So I've taken some hypothetical problem. So let us say K0 is 1 watt per meter Kelvin. It's a hypothetical problem. And from exact solution, we have found that the value of B had taken three different values, 1, 0 and minus 0.01. And okay, yeah, sorry, K in this case, conductivity, this was capital K, so I was confused, this should be small K. The conductivity if you take the variation from 0 degrees, because the boundary condition is left wall it is 0, right wall. Sorry, left wall it is 0 and right wall it is 100 degree centigrade. Okay, so for B is equals to 1, the conductivity varies from 1 to 101. This is a steady state conduction problem with no volumetric heat generation, so temperature has to be within limits, boundary limit 0 and 100. So the K with, when B is 1, it varies from to a very large extent, 1 to 101. When it is minus 0.1, it varies from 1 to 0. But in this case, K is increasing with temperature, here its K is decreasing with temperature. So at the center point, length of the plate which we have taken is 1. So at x equals to 0.5, when you have 0, which means linear variation, you get 0 plus 100 divided by 2. When V is positive at the center, you get 70.4. When V is negative, you get 29.3. So a code is developed, and what we did is that we compared our results with the exact solution, and we find that the results matches exactly. So you can see that V is equal to 0 is the linear variation, which you anyway know, but when V is positive, you get a curve which is convex upward, and when V is negative, you get a curve which is concave upward. Actually, this is one of the questions we typically asked in our MTech interviews, maybe even in PhD interviews we ask, and we always find that the students struggle, and we wonder that why they struggle. I mean, say in undergraduate teaching, what is this, is there any issue? So, because you may be also asking this type of question, is that what is the temperature distribution for one dimensional steady state conduction, and then you make it more complicated saying that conductivity is increasing with temperature, then how it will vary, if it is decreasing then how it varies. I hope that this problem you should at least discuss in the class, so that they have an idea of application of the Fourier law of heat conduction in this case. So to show that actually this is 70.4 and this is 50 and this is 29.3, because this is what you get from the exact solution, I had zoomed on this figure, and you can see that it is close to 70.4, this is 50, and this is indeed close to 29.3. This has been obtained numerically, and this is an exact solution. So I think I had come to the end of this lecture, but if you have any question, I'll be happy to answer. Any question? We have taken two problems, which I called as special topics in heat conduction: multi-solid heat conduction and non-linear heat conduction. Any question? Please raise your hand.
How this non-linearity thermal conductivity taken care in the finite volume?
Okay, I'll, maybe things are not clear, I'll go back to the domain and then I'll explain it. His question is how I incorporate
non-linearity
in the code, you are saying. There what we do is that the idea is something like this. Let me start with the situation. Let us suppose you have a plate which is at, you have taken from a furnace, okay? So everywhere, let us suppose temperature in the plate is 250 degrees centigrade. But suddenly, let us suppose we do something and subject the left wall at 100, bottom wall at 200, right wall at 300, top wall at 400 degrees centigrade, okay? For that material, somebody has done an experiment and he has given some, let us say, table or some expression that K varies with temperature like this. Then what you do is that from the initial condition, you know that all the yellow circle which are interior point will have 250 degrees centigrade, and the boundary point, blue points on the left wall 100, bottom wall 200, right wall 300, top wall 400, correct? So using this, what you can do is that you need conductivity at the faces. So one way of doing it is that you know the temperature at the cell center, so you calculate conductivity at the cell center and take linear interpolation of that. You know, you will have an expression for K as a function of temperature. So if you know the temperature, you can calculate K using that expression. But this K you will be calculating at cell centers, yellow circles and blue circles. So you do linear interpolation because conductivity you need to calculate at the face centers, because heat flux comes at the faces, not at the cell center. So you do linear interpolation of that conductivity, or you take the linear interpolation of temperature and calculate conductivity. So either you do first averaging and then use the expression for K, or calculate K at the cell center and then do average. Either of the two is fine. Okay, so this way you get a matrix for K at all the face centers. Once you know K at all the face center, when you are developing code, you follow the same procedure which I had discussed earlier. But the only difference is that now K will not be a constant value, K will be coming from the matrix. So for a particular cell, you have that value at the face end. When you calculate Qx, Qy, I had shown you yesterday, where do you calculate? Horizontal face center, vertical face center. For this, that row space center, earlier K was constant. In this case, K will be calculated after each time step, and it will be updated in a matrix.
Solving solution procedure, is there any?
We have given you a code for that. So
No. For generating code for this type of problem, non-linear problem.
So what I suggest is that if you understand how to, what I mean is that you look into the codes which we had given to you. I had in my earlier lecture, the slides will also be given to you. there is an implementation detail, there is a solution algorithm, there is a code also. So we hope that, but at least you have to make some effort. I mean, say everything will not be 100% clear through this lecture. But at least we are feeling that you have a lot of resistance in teaching this course. So we are trying to help you. We are ready to help you now also. We are ready to help you later also by email. Okay, but you have to make some effort. That's very important.
Sir, that different material problem,
yeah,
I did with putting additional points at the interface.
Okay.
So whenever it is on the left side, we can use the thermal conductivity of say material 1.
Yeah.
And right side, we can use conductivity of material 2. It is like a boundary point. And it works, and it also gives the interface temperature, which we can compare with the analytical solution.
So what you are saying is that you have found some different method of solution, correct? And you feel that it is working properly. You have not used harmonic mean, that's what you are saying?
Yeah. That harmonic mean is given in that Patankar's book.
Yeah. No, but what you are saying is that you are not using this procedure and still you are getting the correct solution.
Yeah.
So you have found an alternative method, you are saying, correct?
Wherever you have shown that red lines,
yeah,
I put additional point, just like your blue points on the boundary.
But
so zero control volume.
Okay.
So as long as it is on left side, we can use conductivity of material 1.
But what is the boundary condition which you will be using at that? What you're saying is that in this red line, he puts blue circles, correct?
Yeah,
that's what you're saying?
Yeah.
But if you put the blue circles here, you need boundary condition to solve it.
So there we have to ensure that flux is same. So KdT by dx on left equal to KdT by dx on the
right. So actually you are doing it a slightly different way, but I think idea is same. Yeah.
But we can get interface temperature.
No, it's good that you have found some
which we can compare with our analytical solution.
Okay. No, it's good that you have found some alternative method, but the idea remains same. So we are presenting some method, but we'll be more than happy if you come up with some alternate method, but make sure that you get the same result, because finally the physical solution will be one solution. So your numerical formulation should not change the solution.
Sir.
Yeah.
I want to ask some more physical situation, practical case.
Yeah.
There will be some contact resistance.
Yes.
How do you solve that problem?
For that you have to, based on the contact resistance, there will be discontinuity in the heat flux. So from the contact resistance, you calculate what will be the discontinuity, and that can be incorporated in the code. Then the boundary condition will be jump of heat flux, not continuity of heat flux. Then I think the method which he has proposed will be a better one.